Thank you to the both of you for joining us. There is talk of extending Canada-US border restrictions until December 21st. Mayor Diodati, let's start with you. Your thoughts on extending that closure?
Well, I think right now it makes a lot of sense. You know, we're all about bubbles and staying in your bubbles. And right now we're in the Ontario bubble and they're in their bubble, Michigan for Windsor, and of course, New York State for us here in Niagara Falls. I think right now it makes a lot of sense. I know the vaccine is right on the horizon. There's a number of them coming that are having amazing results. Now it's just a matter of timing to get them distributed. So I think a little bit longer isn't going to be bad. And we've always taken the approach, the same as Mayor Dilkens, you know, the short-term pain for long-term gain. And I think we're on our way there.
Mayor Dilkens, the your thoughts on the closure, and of course, that agreement was exempt to healthcare workers and truck drivers. How is that working out?
It's actually worked very, very effectively. And so even if you look at the numbers, the most recent numbers for commercial traffic, they have rebounded to between 85 and 90% of pre-COVID numbers. And so goods continue to flow across the border in both directions, agricultural goods from Windsor and Essex, auto parts, of course, all the Costcos and the Walmarts and the grocery stores on both sides of the border are being filled. And so that is good news. It shows that it's working. And in terms of the healthcare workers, 1,500 for my community cross the border each and every day to serve at hospitals and work at hospitals and healthcare facilities in the state of Michigan. That has not stopped. They've been able to maintain the flow of those important folks. And frankly, had they ever tried to stop that, you would literally have had entire hospitals having to close in the city of Detroit. So the right moves have been made. I agree with Mayor Diodati that the closure is warranted at this point. And when we look at the numbers across the border in the state of Michigan, they're still very, very concerning. And frankly, you know, the beauty of living on a border town is that you have access to these other places on the other side of the border. But the reality is there is no professional sports that you can attend. The restaurants are closed in the state of Michigan. So much is closed down that all of the fun experiences that people are used to appreciating anyway aren't able to happen at this particular time.
Mayor Diodati, how has this affected tourism? How are businesses coping in Niagara Falls, Niagara on the Lake?
It's been a challenge. You know, I say these stats oftentimes that we're the number one leisure destination in Canada. We get upwards of 14 million people here every year, and tourism's huge. 40,000 people count on tourism to put food on the table. So it's something that matters greatly to us. And typically, 25% of those tourists come from the U.S. and they represent 50% of the revenue. So it's been devastating without a doubt to see those bridges closed, to see there be no traffic back and forth. Hotels are very, very low capacity. You know, people have been laid off. It's been devastating for us, no doubt. They call us the canary in the coal mine. We are hit first and hit hardest. And we know we're gonna come out of this because resilience is part of our DNA. And we know that we're challenged with whether it's 9/11, H1N1, the dollar fluctuation, the weather, you know, SARS, mad cow. I mean, it seems there's everything. We joke sometimes. We say the only thing yet is the locust, and I hasten to say that because that might be what's next. But we've dealt with everything, and we're like a rubber band. We'll bounce back. It's just each time you do, you leave some scar tissue, and each time, you know, it hurts. So there's no doubt, but still, having said all that, we figured the most important thing is our safety, number one, and we've been strong. We've marketed the fact that we're safe to play, safetoplay.ca and safetostay.ca. So we try to show people that you can open and you can operate in a safe way. And toward the end of the summer, we did start to pick up. We'll never recover from the losses. I mean, we marked this year with an asterisk. We look forward to better numbers next year, but without a doubt, it's been devastating for this border town in particular because of our dependence on tourism.
Mayor Dilkens, I want to ask you some good news, I guess, for the city of Windsor with respect to the resurgence of the auto sector. We recently heard that Fiat Chrysler was going to invest $1.5 billion in an electric vehicle at a plant there in Windsor. What are your thoughts on this resurgence in Canada's auto sector?
Well, certainly it's a very good sign. And I would add to that also the investment announced by Ford. Part of which will happen in Oakville, but part of it will happen in the city of Windsor as well. So both of those announcements combined are very, very positive signs for the community. Fiat Chrysler is our largest employer in the city of Windsor. And so knowing that they're looking forward, they're looking at the new technology by way of electric vehicles and new energy vehicles is what they're calling it, because hydrogen's around the corner as well. And that we're going to have a piece of that pie down here is very, very exciting. And then hopefully being able to link in our academic institutions like the University of Windsor for some of the real high profile work that needs to be done, the expert work that needs to be done to deliver on these promises, both in the electric vehicle space, but the autonomous vehicle space as well, is really exciting for us.
Mayor Diodati, I want to pick up on a few things that you had mentioned. Gone are those long lineups for cheap gas and groceries and perhaps mailbox services. There are a lot of conversations now that a lot of businesses simply will not survive going through this second lockdown. Mayor Diodati, what do you hear from the businesses that are on the ground? What are they saying to you?
Well, you know, I know Plato said a long time ago that necessity is the mother of invention, and we've had to learn to pivot. And that's a word we hear an awful lot during this pandemic, pivot. And utilizing outdoor spaces, expanding patios onto road allowances and sidewalks, takeout service. You know, they've had to become very resourceful to be successful. And that's exactly what we've done, because we have no choice. We have to survive. So you have to be creative. And they've done exactly that. So no one's looking forward to another lockdown. No one's looking forward to it. But I'll tell you this, we're more resilient the second time around. First time around, no one had PPE. We all have lots of PPE. We all have our Lysol wipes and our disinfectants. We're much more prepared. We're stocked up on, you know, the really important things like toilet paper. You know, we're prepared this time around compared to the last time. So we're more ready. And also with the idea that the vaccine is within sight, several vaccines, in fact, with 90% efficacy rate, which is outstanding. So we're very much looking forward to that. We know the finish line's within sight. So it's kind of that last bit where you go for that last lap, you take one more big breath of air, and then you start swimming. And I think that's how we're feeling. We know that it's tough, especially given Christmas season and the holidays. This is when a lot of those types of businesses pick up with Christmas parties and holiday parties. And it's unfortunate that's not going to happen the way it has in the past, but it's kind of the type of year that it's been, unfortunately.
Mayor Dilkens, of course, that welcome news with the Windsor plant with Fiat Chrysler and with Ford, as you had mentioned. Tell me about the casino there. As I understand it, and as you and I had this conversation offline, that it's limited to 50 people. Tell me about how that has affected the city's finances.
Well, the casino is our largest tourist attraction. They employ over 2,100 people in the Windsor-Essex region. And so they're an important operation, and they're a draw for a lot of talent to come to the city of Windsor by way of the concerts and everything else that they offer. And those folks who come here actually go to one of the 18 wineries. They visit the rest of the county and experience all that there is to offer. And so 30% of their attendance actually comes from across the border. So that, of course, is cut off. But right now, in normal times, the casino could have 10,000 people on the gaming floor. Today, they're limited to 50. And so it's by invitation only to their highest players, where they can possibly, you know, have a chance of breaking even or making a few pennies, you know, along the way. But there is no doubt that there are a lot of people off work who are not able to go back to work because the facility is essentially closed. And we're hoping that, as Mayor Diodati said, that the vaccine is right around the corner, that we can get that out there as quickly as possible in a safe way, so that places like Caesars Windsor can open the doors and welcome guests back in.